Hello, this is Fred Jeff Smith, pastor of Shiloh Missionary Baptist Church. As this is being recorded, it is Monday, March 23rd, and in just a couple of hours, we will be under a stay-at-home order from Governor John Bel Edwards, governor of the state of Louisiana, who announced on yesterday that there would be a stay-at-home order for our entire state until April 13th. Obviously, this changes some of the things that we're going to do here at Shiloh. In the last announcement that I made reference to the fact that our Early Learning Center would continue to be open. But as of 5 o'clock today, our Early Learning Center will be closed for the foreseeable future. If that changes, I will certainly come back and let you know. We do ask that you would continue to follow the governor and the mayor's advice, their guidelines with regard to social distancing, with regard to staying at home, with regard to gathering in numbers, and now the numbers have been shrunk from 50 to 10. We would encourage you to follow their orders as best you can, understanding that they have information that we don't have, and we can probably benefit from heeding their advice. Shiloh will continue to try to operate as best we can under these constraints. We will continue to offer worship on Sunday mornings, but we would ask that you would go exclusively to live streaming our worship experiences. We don't want anyone to come to the church for worship until after April 13th. We will continue to offer Bible study. Again, go to exclusive live streaming. Watch us on live stream at vimeo.com/ShilohBR. I'm sure the graphic will be up on the screen as I'm saying this. We want you to participate in the worship experiences and Bible studies as best you can, but we also want to balance that against the mandates from our government leadership with regard to gathering and social distancing. We don't think that this is a time for us to be afraid. We don't think that this is a time for us to shrink away from our faith, but we do think that this is a time that we should practice prudence, that we should practice wisdom, and to use a little mother wit, we ought to mix our faith with some common sense, and that's what I would like for us to do. I continue to praise the Shiloh Missionary Baptist Church family for the way in which you have responded. Every member of this church has been as cooperative as you possibly can be. I especially want to thank our staff. I want to thank our office staff. Our office is open. We're open now. We will continue to be open until we can no longer be open. So Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. until 5 o'clock p.m., our offices are open. I want to thank our office staff for the wonderful job that they have done. I want to thank our ministerial staff for continuing to serve in the excellent way that they have. I want to thank our audiovisual staff. In particular, I want to thank Terrence Turner for doing a wonderful job in making us available to you through social media. I couldn't do this on my own, but Terrence Turner has made it possible for me to do this, and I'm very appreciative to him for the consistent way that he has given of his time and the generous way in which he has given of his talent. I want to thank the music ministry of our church, Lawrence Abair and Maria Foster, who serve as co-ministers of music, and the entire music ministry team for doing such a wonderful job in providing for us, not just in our worship experiences, but on Saturday for Deacon White's funeral. Under less than ideal circumstances, you have stepped up and you have done a marvelous job. As you have done, I ask that you would continue to do that. I'm grateful to our homeless ministry team. We fed 167 homeless people the other day, and there's a post about that on our Facebook site that you can see. Gail Grover and Ron Markham have given excellent leadership to that ministry, our brotherhood and sisterhood ministry. I want to thank Minister Diane Taylor, who is the head of our Tabitha Sewing Ministry. Minister Taylor has undertaken the task of volunteering to make masks. As you're well aware through national news and local news. There's a shortage of medical masks, and Diane Taylor and her sewing ministry have decided that they're going to undertake the task of making medical masks and donating them to our local hospitals. Shiloh is utilizing every avenue possible to be of service to this community, which is our job. Jesus said that he did not come to be served, but to serve and to offer his life as a ransom for many. We're here to serve, even under extremely difficult circumstances, even under extremely curtailed circumstances. We're here to serve in whatever way we can. We want to be relevant, meaningful, and purposeful. Every evening at 6 o'clock p.m., Shiloh is having prayer by phone, and you're invited to call in and share with us. It doesn't last long, 5 to 10 minutes. We have our regular prayer by phone on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 6 o'clock a.m., but Monday through Friday at 6 o'clock p.m. at the number that is on your screen, we will have prayer by phone throughout this COVID-19 crisis. It's good sometimes just to gather, just to hear other voices, just to share our concerns one with the other, and we invite you to partake in that. During this time, it is very important that members of Shiloh continue to practice excellent stewardship. Shiloh is blessed to have a wonderful membership that practices consistent stewardship. We need you to continue that consistency during this time. Even though you can't come to the church, you can see to it that your funds are sent to the church so that we can continue to provide ministry. Now, I've noticed that there are some people who are critical of churches and pastors who ask for funds during this critical time in the life of our nation and truly in the world. Some people see it as gouging. Some people see it as selfishness. I simply want to respond this way by saying that ministry can't be done without money. It's the only way that it can happen. And as I said to the members of Shiloh on yesterday, our giving is not just to the church. Our giving is to God. It is a response to how the Lord has blessed us. When we give, it is as much an act of worship as praying, as singing, as preaching. And so we want you to continue to worship the Lord through the giving of your gifts to His church. Bring all the tithe to the storehouse, is the word from the Lord. If you're offended by that, if that's something that you don't feel like you should do, then by all means, don't do it, because we're told that we should not do it grudgingly, nor of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. There are ways in which you can give. You can give through our MyeOffering app found at our website. You can bring your gifts to the church and give them to us. As I have told you, the office is open. You can use your bill pay method at your financial institution in order to make your gifts known to us. And watch for other ways over the days that are to come when we will make other avenues available for your giving to take place. Again, we are here to service you. If there's a way that we can be of greater service to you, please feel free to contact me. You can reach me at fredjeffsmith@cox.net. fredjeffsmith@cox.net. You can also reach me on my Facebook page. I use my Facebook page all the time, and I would love to hear from you of ways that we can better service our community. God is going to see us through this. And we're going to come out of this with a wonderful story to tell about how good our God has been to us. Take care of yourself. Stay safe. God bless you.